I knew that it was a, you know, they had a wonderful roster of dancers, and I knew that they had a great rep that I was familiar with. But for me, it really the thing that nailed it, honestly, is when I started to come down to Miami and I just saw how the community had changed. When I left 40 years ago, I left Miami because I had to. If I wanted to dance, I could not do it here. And that all had changed. And because a dance company can only survive if it's supported by its community. Clearly, the work that Edward did was extraordinary. The hardest thing in the world is to start a ballet company. My sense as I look around is that there's a renaissance that has happened in this place. And Miami City Ballet, we have the opportunity to grab that and kind of ride that wave, but ride it artistically at a very, very high level. So you're right, 25 years is not that long, but it's pretty long for, you know, for a company that started from scratch and has survived. I'm sure some, you know, very difficult transitions in terms of the community. Both school and company are really truly a family. The dancers, not only do they work together, but they hang out together, they room together, they go out to, you know, they're truly, truly brothers and sisters. And so I was a stranger walking in, and it was really a moment, it was a gulp moment. You know, because we come from something, and that's very important. But I also think that we have to look into the future. And you know, you look at some of the great choreographers, the Balanchine, you know, Robbins, Cunningham, Taylor, Fokine, Massine, and these are people who broke the mold. They broke their parameters, basically. And so, and that's why they're innovative, and that's why we still do these works. So to just do that defeats the purpose of the evolution of the art form. I'm very excited about next season. I'm really excited. I can't even believe that it's happening. It's a very ambitious season. It's a scary season for me, but it's an ambitious season because there are four new works in that we're premiering, and that's a lot for any company. That's a lot for any company. And they're works that are challenging for the dancers and challenging for audiences. But that's why I did it, because I wanted each program have something exciting built around it.
Go down. Go down.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So here we go. Ready? Great.
Because I don't want to do things that are gimmicky. I want to do things that feel right and real. And when I thought of both The Heat and Miami City Ballet, I realized that they were, you know, companies that chose this area to start from scratch, from the bottom up. You know, they chose Miami to start these ventures, these adventures. And they were, you know, basically about the same age, 25 and 27 years old. But more importantly, when you look at basketball, it's really grace under pressure. I mean, it's grace, it's timing, it's agility, it's strength, but they're real artists, as are the ballet dancers. So there's a similarity there between the basketball players and dancers. And so when I thought about all of that, I said, you know what? Let's do this, but let's make sure that in the photo shoots, the dancers are presented in a way that's appealing, that's young, that's vibrant, that, you know, sexy is fine, but that they're respectful, you know, that it's respectful to who they are as artists and to the art form. And I think we pulled it off. I mean, I'm really excited about it. It put us in front of an audience that we would never have gotten in front of. It called the attention to us in a great way. The dancers had a great time. I mean, meeting these heroes. I had a great time. I was like, whoa. It was just, you know, exciting and positive all around. I would love to see Miami City Ballet actually have longer season in its hometown, so that we're not here 5 weekends a year, but we're here, you know, we do 3 months and then we do another 2 months. I would love to see it perform in other venues, in different smaller theaters for different communities, different works. I'd love to see it tour nationally. Obviously is very important, but more important for me is Latin and South America. I'd love a foothold there where there's a real relationship, a real residency, almost almost going down there every year at the, you know, and creating these tours and creating relationships. That's the Miami City Ballet that I see.